everybody. This video is about our next year-long make-along I want to host on Instagram. I will also open a Ravelry thread so you can exchange patterns and link to them and to your project pages, but it will be an Instagram knit-along and I will draw winners from Instagram. Okay, what is this knit-along? We will do the Anna Knitter Blanket-Along. I did this in 2018, I think, already, or 2017, I don't know now. And I want to do it again because we all enjoy making blankets. Scrappy blankets or pretty designed blankets, fingering weight yarn blankets or chunky yarn weight blankets, whatever you want to knit or to crochet or to sew or to weave or whatever. What do you need to know about this knit along? We will start on New Year's Eve. Okay, you can cast on or start to sew a new blanket, or you just put out your whip. Maybe you have something hibernating or languishing you haven't touched for a very long time, and this is the inspiration to finally finish it, or at least to work on it again. So New Year's Eve, we will use the hashtag AnnaKnitterBlanketAlong. Only posts with the hashtag AnnaKnitterBlanketAlong will be able to be a winning post, and I will draw winners periodically throughout the year of 2022, and you will most likely receive yarns and maybe sometimes patterns. I will post monthly update videos on YouTube, maybe also on Instagram, so you always see how much I have done on my current blankets. Maybe you want to show me your blanket updates as well, and you can tag me, so Anna-Lena Knitter on Instagram, and I see also your projects, because that is something I'm very curious about. Okay, now we come to blankets in general. As you can see, I have made several blankets already. This one is my whip. I will talk about this after I have shown you all the other blankets. Okay, in the following updates, I will show you the blankets in detail. Now I will just give you an idea. Okay. Here we have the granny stripe blanket. It's completely out of leftovers and minis. This was my granny square blanket I used as my cozy memories blanket. That was before I found out how I can make my dot squares in an easy way. This is also only made from minis and leftovers. This is my temperature blanket. It's a crochet blanket again. As you can see, I have only crocheted blanket. So finished blankets are only crochet blankets. And this one is my Christmas blanket. This is the cozy striped blanket by Attic24, but I have invented, so to say, the color repeats. You can find everything on my project pages, how I managed to make the colors, the striping, and that, yeah, that the pattern and the color striping don't repeat themselves too much. Okay, so you see, I love making blankets. And now we come to my current blanket project. It's my Cozy Memories blanket. I knit inspired by the Bryony Bears as the In Stitch and Time blanket. So I do color blocks. So I do different color blocks. And then, so a finished block looks like this. I frame everything, and I will explain this in my next blanket update in detail. I will go over all the blankets in the next updates. So this is a finished block. I will go on about this in detail in my next blanket update, because now I have two finished blocks and I'm working on my third one, and I hope to have this done next month, and then I could show you a tutorial how I do this, because I don't like sewing something together, and that is why I crochet them together. Better done than perfect is my motto. That is my blank Annaneta Blanket Along project, and I want to cast on. So crazy, but yeah, I want to cast on another Cozy Memories blanket on New Year's Eve. So when our knit along will or make along will start, I want to cast on the Cozy Memories blanket how Ina knits her blanket. So I will link to her tutorial in the description box below. Her blanket is, you start every square with a solid color, and then you add your mini. You pick up the stitches and cast on directly on the next square. You have every square framed by a solid color. And when I say this now, it might sound confusing, so just watch her tutorial, it's very easy. You knit the blanket just as a normal Cozy Memories blanket, but instead of starting right away with your mini, so your colorful yarn, you knit the first, for example, 5 rows in a solid color, always in the same solid color. So at the end, every square is framed, and that makes a very pretty and tidy look. I did color palettes because I don't like the Cozy Memories blanket that go completely wild, you know. But I also don't want to make a designed one, so for example only pastel, only blues or only darks or so, because I wouldn't finish that blanket. I want to just add every mini I have, every leftover I have, and that will be so much easier if you frame every square with a solid color, because that makes it very pretty, and you can knit pink and red next to each other, for example, because it's white in between and that won't clash the colors. Yeah. When I do my monthly blanket update videos, I will, as I told you, periodically throughout the year draw and announce winners from the hashtag on Instagram, AnnaKnitterBlanketAlong. I hope you will participate, and I will show you some of the blankets that I like very much, or the projects I like very much I saw on the hashtag, and I will share with you here on YouTube. So that is a shout out for you, for your creators, that you also will be part of this video series. And now, I hope you participate. I hope you sort your minis. In my next blanket update video, I want to show you my minis and leftovers stash. I want to talk to you about how I knit my blankets. And in every update, I will talk about always about another blanket I have knit or crocheted, how I did this, so you get inspired. Maybe you want to start other projects. So there will be enough content for the monthly blanket update videos. So get ready, and I hope I see you on the hashtag feed AnnaKnitterBlanketAlong on New Year's Eve, because I want to celebrate the start into the new year with you all together, with your hooks and needles and the yarns. I'm looking forward to that very much. Yeah, thank you for participating, and see you next time. Bye bye.